we use a mechanism called fingerprints, which basically tries to collect all those isolates which do the same set of mutations. So if one new change happens, it creates a new fingerprint. So what we have seen now is out of around 1 million genomes which we processed so far, 500,000 are showing as mutation fingerprint variants. And in this case, there are some very important ones where mutations are appearing in the receptor binding domain, which is the region which connects to let the virus enter into the human cells. And if some changes happen there in the receptor binding domain, then it can increase the infectivity or disease severity, for example. And what we have seen is that the UK variant, for example, has a mutation in the receptor binding domain, N501Y, and this became the most fastest spreading version of the new virus. So based on mutations which are appearing in the receptor binding domain, there are three or four variants of concern. Others are variants of interest, but what we are trying to do is to track any mutation which appears into the receptor binding domain, which could impact mutations, which might have a serious impact on infectivity or the severity of the disease.
It is important to analyze the whole genome sequence information of this virus. So fortunately, in Germany, there is a database called GIS-AID, in which they are constructing the database of whole viral genome for COVID-19 virus. Then every day we upload those information to our system. So therefore our mutation tracker system can show the latest update of mutation tracking information. Then the scientists and the public health authorities can take appropriate action in a timely fashion.